out again today to my favourite part of the country again. We're down doing another wild camp. Hopefully the last one was good fun. Yeah, so we're going up to Moss, hopefully. If I can hold myself up there. It's always intimidating looking at it. Again, we'll see when we get up there. At least get up to the call anyway. See how that goes. It's another cracking day. It is beautiful. And somehow I've managed with the whole day ahead of me to leave myself rushing. I couldn't organise it. So anyway. So this is part of the Dingle Way. We parked at Tier, just above Brandon. And it's part of the Dingle Way up to the Col. You'd have seen it in the Moss video. That's where the Ormstone is. Jesus, that looks terrible. So we're just working our way up there. Behind us here, then you've all the usual suspects being skiing. I don't think I actually have a video coming this direction. I've been up here a good few times, but I don't have any video coming this direction. So we get to see the steps going up to the Col between Moss and Pierce. I met Raffle and Mags at the car park that I'd met in the Sauce Creek video. Hello again, guys. It's lovely to meet you. So I hope you have a great night. What you were describing happening sounded absolutely fantastic. So we'll keep going. See how far we can get before the body says it's taking a break. So that's the whole fat ridge behind me there, with Brendan Peak in the distance. This is a good old haul up. The Faha Grotto then is at the other side of that ridge up. Yeah, everything looks fantastic. So look, we'll put this away. We'll make tracks just to try and get up there so I'm not faffing around unnecessarily. And we'll see how we go, right? Old village here now is called Arraglen. There was 13 families used to live here after having a dispute with neighbours in Brandon Point. So it is a fairly crap reason for having to live here, but it's a stunning location, and you have the stream coming off the mountain as well. But I think you could see all the ruined buildings in the drone shots there. And that was used, you can see there's bags and stuff down there, so whatever's been used. Just over there behind me is Sauce Creek. So we'd have been on the other side of that for the last video, the last camp. So it's all the same area, but it is a lovely area. It is. And we're going up there now. I know I said in one of my old videos, Pierce Moor, you should always, well, not always, but it is a handy one to know. But that's it up there, the point. It is very distinctive in Moss, then there's a lump on the left. So we're making great time. That was very enjoyable coming up there. Very nice, relaxed. Start of it was a small bit steep, but overall it was fine. So we're heading up now in the final stretch. Well, not the final stretch, there's still a few kilometres to the Col. Yeah, that'll be fine. Just put the head down. It's okay most of the way in, but then it gets steep near the end of it, but they have steps put in. So it'll be fine. Yeah. They're so quiet here, there's nothing going on like. So yeah, anyway, we're gonna head away now and try and make some reasonable time. I mentioned on a previous moss video that there was a nice plaque here. This is a signboard, just mentioning it. Vickers Wellington HF208, Crashdown Ridge of Mount Brandon, Arraglen, County Kerry. So that's a nice info board there. If you just come up here then, there's a lot older looking kind of plaque on the wall. Yeah, the old route up, I think I said a few minutes ago, it's steep for a bit and then it flattens out. It doesn't flatten out, it's all uphill. So it's a good old slog. But again, the path is fine to work. So that's all kind of gravelly, and it looks like now we're changing into a bit more grassy. And I know there's kind of steps up above as well. The sun will drop down now fairly quick behind that, so we're still a long way from sunset though. It might make it a bit cooler. It's so warm, there's no wind there at all. It's just very warm. And the reason there's no midges, there was a carcass down there, I'd say they're all stuck in the carcass. Familiar ground there now. We just came up to the Ohm Stone that you seen in the last moss video. So we came up this way previously and we went over to Pierce then along the ridge over to Brandon. But tonight, you know, much like the last night, hopefully you're going to stay above on top of moss. If it doesn't work out, I can always drop off down because there's loads of places around here flat enough with good enough grounds that it'll be able to set up a tent. So yeah, sure, we'll go up and see what it's like anyway. But there's some cracking view when you come in, isn't it? You come up off the steps, the pet there, and honestly, some of that pet is coming up through very boggy ground. It'd be a nightmare to do with it if it wasn't there. I've never come up that way when it wasn't there, but I definitely appreciate it. It is brilliant to the crowd that did it. Good job, well done. Who am I to be telling anyone good job? But it's fantastic, it really helps. And then you're looking along the whole lot there. Right, we'll make tracks up to the top of moss here and see how we get on. We're doing all right time wise, but I don't want to be messing around too much. Top of moss now, been up here quite a while. Set the tent up, got ready, relaxed a bit. The last pull up there from the call was, it was actually fine. It was tough, but it was okay. Carrying the load in the back is a big one. There was the house for the night, not a bad view. And a small thing, I know the last time I was up here I said, it was a very grassy top, all things considered. It's not grassy at all, it's just an inch of moss. The next thing is just all rock, because trying to put pegs into the ground is a bit of a nightmare. So I'm after staking out the tent with rocks to put tension on the lines and stuff. It's not perfect, but it's my first time doing it, so I'm happy enough with it. And the wind isn't supposed to be too bad tonight. Yeah, slight breeze here enough. Where I am in the tent there's no breeze, and the midges are beginning to make an appearance. And of course, I've no midgy stuff with me. But yeah, it's just views everywhere. I can't get over how calm it is. I put up a clip there now of the last time I was up here, and had the neck thing up around the head, and it was fucking Baltic. But it's pretty amazing. That was a cracking sunset again. There's two of them now in the last few days that have just been. Enjoy, like, there's no foreground, obviously, when you're up in the top, there's not much. But to just to see the colours in the sky there. We're getting on now to 20 past 10. It'll start to get dark now and then start to get bright. Soon enough, sunrise is early. That's the thing about sunrises and our summer sunrises here. And sunsets, they can be both late and early, so. Right, we go in and relax for the rest of the evening. Hopefully we got some drone shots there. And then we just take in the last of the light. And just enjoy it for what it is. We'll see you tomorrow. We're finishing up here now with a very relaxing morning when there's no mist and cloud to contend with. You can just take your time and do your bits. And yeah, but sure, looking back at that view, it wouldn't be going anywhere anyway. It took a while for the peninsula to brighten up, but you could see the shadow being cast by the mountains. They were coming back, and now the sun is pretty much up. So, and sure, we also had, looking back up the rest of the peninsula, it's very washed out now, which was really nice at the start with the sunrise. So we're going to make our way down now. Again, no rush. It's still cool enough. In fairness, it is. When I was doing the bits around there, tidying up and stuff afterwards, it was warm. But no doubt, as you start working downwards and as the sun starts going higher, it'll be getting warmer. It's a spectacular view up along the peninsula there. I won't go on about it. I'm sure you said it enough times last night. Yeah, we go down the spine here to Moss and down to Arraglen, whatever it is like. I did it before. So, instead of going the steps, and I'll give a report as we're going down to see if there's any better. So, because there is a walking man post here, and I've seen in one or two of the local websites that tis a route. So, you might as well check it out. Sulaud, Moss and Champin. It's actually very good. I'm only just off the top a tiny bit there. 2 or 3 minutes. That's the new path on the way up, which was brilliant. I think I said it last night. But it really shows that the path all the way down. And you can see the whole route down to Arraglen there, just at the corner then. And then we shoot right at Arraglen. and you can see the road all the way back to Tir. We're finding another walking man post. So you can see up there, that's not moss, no, that's a ridge further down, but we came down that ridge there. When you look back up at it, you think, holy shit, but you just have to mind yourself coming down. The top half coming down from moss, there was a path. Everything is bone dry, so everything is fine. There was a path, but then it kind of petered out, but it didn't matter, because you were onto that ridge then, and you were just coming through heather. But if it was wet, to be slippery enough. But yeah, it's good fun coming down it, even with the big backpack. And we're coming here now, not far above Arraglen. There's a massive herd of, I think, wild goat. Again, I don't know what constitutes massive in wild goat terms, but there's a huge, well, I call them a big herd of them. They're all very wary of me, so I'll try and stick to the right of them. Don't want to be seeing them scattering. They're worse than sheep, to be honest. Enough moss there now, and we cut across the plateau here. You can hear the skylarks again. They're not high birds, obviously. So yeah, we came down off moss there. Very nice, very dry, like I said. And then we're at a place here on the map. It's called Point Coma Jutta, D-H-O-I-T-E. I don't know what that means, but there's a massive wall here. Goes here and goes all the way off down the edge there as well. It's a ton of work here, and it's the other way here as well. And you can see then Arraglen is just behind us. All right, it's you can see moss there behind me. In case anyone's wondering where it is, when you're leaving Tralee, you can see the end of the peninsula. It's the big hump there, or when you're coming out of camp, it's even more prominent again. But yeah, you can see it, and when you're over in Ballyhigh and Banna and Fianna, tis the first one in the range you see. And obviously Pyrrhusmore then is the good pointer beside it. It's warm now, I just met two people going up there. Wouldn't like to be going up in this weather. So we'll finish up. I don't think there's any point in showing more clips, but it's just to be last night's clips in reverse. That we'll finish up. It's been a great two nights camping over the last few days. Yeah, the weather played ball, it was nice to get it. So look, thanks again for watching. You might like and subscribe. And hopefully we'll see you guys in the next one. Good luck.